Mr. President, I am Reverend Father Teresa Sivanov.
In a video apparently recorded under duress, a Roman Catholic priest in the Philippines is seen asking President Rodrigo Duterte to ease off his battle against militants linked to Islamic State in the city of Marawi.
Mr. President, from our heart, please consider us.
Priest Teresito Suganob and 200 others were reportedly held hostage by Maute, an extremist group that wants to establish a caliphate in the southern Philippines. In Marawi, the army is fighting against Islamic State-linked militants who have occupied this city of 200,000 people, stoking fears of an expansion of Islamic State in Southeast Asia.
Government must put an end to this.
Duterte has declared 60 days of martial law on the island of Mindanao, which is home to 22 million people. Maute fighters occupied Marawi last week after soldiers tried to arrest Isnilon Hapilon, a jihadist who leads Abu Sayyaf, an affiliated extremist group. Abu Sayyaf also wants to create a caliphate in the southern Philippines.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Abu Sayyaf had been allied with Al-Qaeda since the mid-1990s before declaring its allegiance to Islamic State in 2014. Islamic State has declared Hapilon its emir, or leader, in the Philippines.
So you can say that the ISIS is here already.
The Maute group has been accused of being involved in the bombing of President Duterte's hometown, Davao, last year.
And about half of that number are foreign terrorists.
Government officials said last week that foreign Islamist fighters have joined Maute, raising fears that Mindanao could become a regional stronghold of Islamic State. Mindanao has long been a hotbed of local insurgencies and separatist movements.
You're going to fight? I have to fight every day until this conflict is resolved.
Duterte's spokesman said the president is committed to restoring peace and order in Mindanao and is focused on the terrorist threat. Thousands of civilians fled their homes in Marawi to seek shelter and aid nearby. Some people hoisted white flags to avoid being targeted by soldiers.
Natamaan yung dinaanan ko ng helicopter. Nabuntik ako, nahulog ako doon. Pagkatapos yung bahay namin.
After days of fighting that included troops bombarding the city with airstrikes and mortar fire, authorities say that they have taken back control of most of the city. But the fugitive militant leader Hapilon remains at large. Despite Duterte's heavy-handed approach, concerns persist over the army's ability to keep the situation in the southern region under control.